showcase. My class focused on learning about Sarajevo. First of all, we were inspired by this book, Flowers for Sarajevo, by John McHutchinson, illustrated by Christy Caldwell. In this class, my students learned about increasing cultural conflict and how this can lead to cultural violence. In the 1990s, when Sarajevo was the capital of Yugoslavia. Throughout this class, my students learned about the geographical changes that this area of the world faced, as well as historical influences. One of the things that inspired me with this book, and also inspired my students, was that the fine arts are one of the best ways to cure the heart after major destruction and violence. So we hope that you see and enjoy this as well. I would like to thank Diesel and Benjamin for writing our script. One thing that you need to know is that this entire production was student-led, from script to props to staging to costumes, everything. They let me just be their guide, which I appreciate. Thank you, everyone. And I think we're ready. So, we welcome you to Bosnia, Sarajevo, Yugoslavia, on May 27th, 1992. The last thing I'd like to say to you is a quote. This will be our reply to violence, to make music more intensely, more beautifully, more devotedly than ever before. Leonard Bernstein. Please note that this is based on real historical events. Welcome to Sarajevo.
Like these flowers, we manage to live side by side, even though Goran.
Believe it, Krasko. Underneath that flirting hide, there's a beautiful heart.
Yeah. I understand giving flowers to little Gertie or poor Miss Novak. To me, it's man of market. My father's a mystery to me. Many things are a mystery to me.
We wonder how so much can change so quickly. Overnight, it seems we are at war. Our country is tearing apart. Every day, men are leaving for the battlefield.
My father. Now it's my time to keep the flowers fresh and our family fed. But I'm only a boy.
The merchants who are our friends are tired and bad-tempered. They have pushed into the worst corner of the square. No shade, no water for flowers. Now he's even too far from the bakery to enjoy the sweet smell of fresh bread, where once they had kind words and treats for him. Now it's
move on, Drasko. Not here, Drasko.
Out of my way, Drasko.
Still, there is one good thing about this spot. Behind his stall stands the building where the orchestra practices. Thanks to the window, they leave open to warm May breezes. He can hear every note.
I have the best seat on the square. This morning, Marjorie Vorka plays music I remember from when I was small. Oh. clubhouse laughing. Today, close my eyes with music carrying me far away from this crowded, lonely place.
It's 10 o'clock. The next day, the square is strangely still. 22 people were killed. They were just waiting to buy bread. The church bells ring. 10 o'clock again.
I've seen him before, a man with an extraordinary mustache.
Today, he is dressed in a tuxedo, as if he is going to a concert. In one hand, he carries a chair, in the other, a violin. He steps carefully through the rubble and stops near the crater in front of the bakery. He sits and places his bow to the string. The people who have gathered look on in silence.
All of us, Serb and Croat, Muslim and Christian, stand side by side, listening to a language we all understand.
Why are you playing where there is Bobby?
Why are you bombing where I am playing?
Of Sarajevo to fill the hole that more left in us.
The following day, at exactly 10 o'clock, the violinist plays again. The day after that is the same, and the next. For 22 days, he plays. One day for each person in the loft at the bakery. One day for each family.
Every night I say 22 prayers and one more for my father.
The war is not over yet. The people have come back to square. The bakeries open doors, and again music floats down from a window above my flower stalk.
He has his father's nose for flowers, this one. Just like your father, giving away what you should sell.
Tomorrow, like my father, like the violinist,
we'll do our own small part to make Sarajevo beautiful once again.